are the top three things that you need to start eating? Number one, rice. All right, rice needs to come back on your plate. Rice, especially in the nights, needs to come back on your plates. All right, and the reason why rice needs to be there is because why did we first take out rice?
Carbs.
Okay, carbs, starch, and the likes. Every time that you think about food in terms of carbs, proteins, and fat, who are the people who benefit? The food industry. Okay, it's never the people, it's never the farmers, it's never the food system, because then you can actually have things like carb-free rice. Yum, you know, fiber wala rice,
cauliflower,
brown rice, cauliflower wala rice, black rice, jasmine rice, all kinds of rice. But what you need to go back to is like the regular rice that you used to eat. Rice does look white in color. It is easy to digest and it works as a prebiotic. Are you aware of what is a prebiotic?
Yeah.
So prebiotic is food for the probiotic, the good bacteria in your stomach. So rice needs to come back. And is rice easy to cook?
Yes.
Yeah. But where will you cook it?
Gas stove.
Yeah, but not on that Insta pot. Rice to regular isme cook karo. Who should be cooking the rice at home?
Husband.
Of course, Indian man, all right? Because you come here for a certain kind of life, then the man has to learn to cook. I think when they give citizenship to Indians, they have to first ask, aapka husband cook karega? So then at least you've like earned your citizenship, yeah? So yeah, cook your rice and then eat it. This is point one. Eat it with different kinds of legumes, dals or pulses. Right now, hum log ka jo dal ka portfolio hai is limited. Moong, tuwar, full stop. Correct? But you come from a heritage which has a diversity of 65,000 varieties of pulses. So what you will need to do here is look for at least 12 or 15 and then eat them through the month. So the ones that you should really be eating in the winter are, of course, you can eat your moong and you can eat your tuwar. But the one thing that you need to add is kurit or horse gram. Yeah? And you will find it anywhere. Whole Foods se leke Patel store tak. It's everywhere. And it goes... horse gram is the one dal that you need to use, especially good for everything skin. Anyone having gallbladder or kidney stone issues after moving here? Yeah, a few, right? So kurit is something that helps even in those cases. So wo zarur use karna. The second one that you need to start using is this red color ka choli.
Yes.
Yeah. So wo bhi milta hai aapke yahan pe. So wo bhi use karna. And the third one is either a green or a black chana. You know the smaller chana.
Yeah.
Not the white color ka chana. Desi chana. Ye jo navratra mein jo jiska wo banta hai, that black, small black chana. So that chana is what you should be using. So I've given you at least 5. You will, you know, work at getting many more. Yahan ke kaun kaun se local beans hai? There is something called as, I think, garbanzo beans. White chana. Aur kya hai?
Pinto.
Lima beans, yeah. So get at least 2-3 from here, 7-8 from your heritage, but make only one at one time. Okay, these are just the 5 that I'm saying you must include, but of course everything that you have, you must, you know, lobia, matkis and cholis and sab kuch, rajma, 12, 15, 17, 18, jitna apna aapka portfolio aap diversify kar paoge, utna zyada bacterial diversity badhta hai. So very important for bacterial diversity, very important for everyone who has children to get them to eat these different kinds of dal. So this is the one thing that you must include, rice and legumes. The second thing that you need to include in your diet, and this is specific also to the winters that are coming, all kinds of root vegetables. So sub type ka, you know, sweet potatoes, arbi. और आपके यहाँ पे क्या क्या मिलता है? There is one purple color का thing also.
Turnip,
yam, even potatoes, because I think there is something called as heritage potatoes that you get here, you know, with the, like with the more local seed. So all kinds of root vegetables is what you should be working at including, and this is safe for people with diabetes, and this is specially recommended for women with PCOD thyroid problems. This is also good for all people who have vitamin D and B12 ka deficiency, because you have to realize that it's only in the winters that the vitamin D also drops. You know why vitamin D drops? Because vitamin D ka assimilation is related to microbial diversity, sunlight, yes, but also microbial diversity. जब डाइवर्सिटी श्रिंक होता है, ऑफ कोर्स विटामिन डी का शॉट्स लेने के बाद या मेगा डोसेस लेने के बाद भी और नेवर सफिशिएंट ऑन विटामिन डी. एंड देन व्हेन यू आर नॉट सफिशिएंट ऑन विटामिन डी, यू हैव दिस लिटिल ब्लोटिंग, यू स्लीप डिफरेंटली, मोर डिस्टर्ब्ड इन द नाइट्स, यू वेक अप ऑल द टाइम इन द नाइट वांटिंग टू गो टू सुसु, कम बैक टू बेड, ड्रिंक वाटर, स्लीप अगेन, गेट अप, यू नो दैट होल रूटीन दैट वी कीप डूइंग. So vitamin D is important, but then to keep that diversity, again you need prebiotics. All of these are excellent sources of the prebiotic bacteria. So use all of these root vegetables, even carrots. I think now you have like these carrots which are like of multiple colors here.
Yeah.
Right? So get those big multiple color carrots. You just need to make intelligent decisions, like aap just bhi shop mein jaate ho. You have the full carrot and then you have a cut carrot in the plastic bag. So get the full ones and not the cut ones, okay? So as much as you can, try and patronize the local farming movement here. Local farmers market and stuff. So include these root vegetables. And when you're making these root vegetables, cook them with the sendha or the kala namak. Yeah, the sendha namak, kala namak, jada namak, sea salt, you know, different varieties of salt, because that is what will help you keep the whole bloating down. Cool. So this is the second thing that you need to add. The third thing that needs to come into your diet is obviously my favorite, and something I guess which you will all know. Ghee. But not on top of your coffee, on top of your roll. So ghee is extremely important. Even white makhan, if you can have access to that, because I think there are some places where you get this cultured raw butter or something like that, right? So that's like a version of white butter. Ghee is safe even for those who are lactose intolerant. But how to eat ghee while you're here and when you have harsh winters? So the way to eat ghee here is to, of course, eat it every day on your dal, chawal and legume and everything, but eat it in a little higher amounts along with bajra, makai and ragi, okay? And once every week use either bajra ya makai ka atta, okay? Because otherwise aap log kya use karte ho ghar pe? Rotis, right? So can you start making something with bajra? So if making a chapati or a bhakri is difficult with bajra, what you can do is roll it into like laddus, okay? There are many recipes of making even namkeen laddu with bajra. You just need to roast bajra with like a lot of ghee and little jeera and namak and stuff like that. You roll it and you keep it, and you can just have that once every day. It can even be lunch with like a little bit of dahi, yeah, or lunch with a little bit of vegetables that you have cooked. So one bajra ka laddu aur kal raat ka banaya hua sabzi is sorted, like next day ka lunch can get sorted with something like that. Nachni can easily turn into a dosa. So, you know, you just put little najni, put a little bit of dahi or just water, and then you mix that batter, let it stand for a little while, and then exactly like the way you make a dosa. But then when you make a dosa, make it on iron ka tawa, not on one of your non-stick tawas, iron tawa. Taki wo pura jo ghee aap usme dal rahe ho, wo usko soak kare. And that it also adds that little bit of iron back into your stomach. How can you eat makai? Makai can easily can roll itself into a chapati. So that is not such a tough one. The bajra and najni can be a little tough. So will you start including these in your diet? So every week this winter, there should be at least twice a week that you're eating millets. At least twice, yeah? And not in the form of, I mean, yeah, not like those takeaway salad wala millets. Ghar par banaya hua millets. Cooking, especially the way we cook, it actually brings together many things that your gourmet salad bowls bring together, right? Whether it is seeds, whether it is essential fats, whether it is millets, whether it is legumes or beans or veggies. Now, all that we have to do is focus on how we make it in our kitchens and really work at eating like the way we have learned we should eat, okay? So, a quick recap of the three things that you need to be doing. Rice along with legumes every night, because like that is easy to do, okay? Usme zyada tension nahi hai. And get the men in your house to cook. Yes. Not just while they're dating. Way later. The second thing,
root vegetables.
Yeah, yes. Is all root vegetables. They need to come onto your plate. Yeah, and you can either make a sabzi out of it, or you can have it as a snack by about 4 or 5 o'clock in the evening, because that's the one time when hunger strikes and we really don't know what to do. That's also the time when we make all our mistakes with food. Yeah, what do you guys do here? What are your mistakes? Cookies?
Whatever.
Seriously. Yeah. There is no vada pav wala to go. No samosa, no safe food. You know, if you are in Mumbai and you are frustrated at 4 o'clock, you call, bhaiya, go safe food. At least, khane ke baad mein sukoon lagta hai. So, now you don't have all of those things. So, you have to plan ahead, okay? So, yeah. All of these root vegetables, agar kisi din nahi hua, aapne cook karke nahi aap leke gaye ho ya roast karke nahi leke gaye ho. You guys also do a lot of barbecues, right?
Yes.
So this is also good stuff for barbecue. Yeah? Is it barbecue season?
No.
No. Ugly bar. But this time pe at least cook karo ya roast karo jo bhi. Aur wo agar nahi hua to banana khao. Banana is a good thing to have between 4 and 5. What this ensures is that the dinner that you're eating is light. That's one thing that it ensures. The other thing that it ensures is that you actually sleep well. Because have you heard of this hormone called cortisol?
Yes.
Yeah.
Stress.
So cortisol is called as the stress hormone. Now every hormone in our body has a natural rhythm in which it moves. So cortisol, when it works in its natural rhythm, peaks at 6 a.m. in the morning and dips at 6 p.m. But when your gut bacterial diversity begins to get compromised, it begins to like dip in the morning and peak in the evenings. So, raat ko neend nahi aati hai aur din ka chain chala jata hai, and you're not even in love with anyone. You're just messed up with your cortisol. So, raat ko you feel like, oh, कौन जागा रहेगा अभी इंडिया में किसको एंड इन द मॉर्निंग व्हेन यू रियली वांट टू वेक अप यू आर जस्ट अनएबल टू बिकॉज दैट्स व्हेन यू एक्चुअली फील यू आर गोइंग टू फॉल अस्लीप यू नो समवेयर एट 3:30 4 o'clock 5 o'clock इज व्हेन यू फॉल अस्लीप एंड यू आर लाइक अरे ऑलरेडी 6 क्यों बजा व्हाई कांट इट बी 5:45 एंड यू नो दिस होल बिजनेस ऑफ अलार्म ऑन स्नूज बहुत लोग स्नूज पे लगाते हैं, वो लोग को सोते हुए ही मालूम रहता है थर्ड स्नूज पे ही होता है। तो थर्ड वाला ही अलार्म लगा हुआ है, टॉर्चरिंग हो सकता है। आई थिंक दिस इज एन इंडियन मेंटालिटी, खुद को टॉर्चर कर करके कर फिर ही उठेंगे, यू नो। सो इफ यू हैव दैट 4 or 6 PM मील, इट विल एंश्योर दैट द कॉर्टिसोल बिगिंस टू डिप इन द इवनिंग, सो यू विल बी लेस हंग्री फॉर डिनर। Whatever that you have cooked, that rice or dal or khichdi or whatever, will be more than enough for you. You will sleep better, you will wake up fresher. And once you sleep better, you also have, you retain better bacterial diversity. You know, otherwise people wake up in the morning say, today I am looking fat. You know, by the time you are, it's afternoon, abhi main patli ho gayi. Wapis shaam ke 7:30-8 baje, wapis moti ho gayi. So this din mein jo body badalta hai, pure din mein, that is all because of this. So eat that meal between 4 and 6. And lastly, of course, eat your ghee, eat your white makhan. But now make sure that you're eating at least 2 millets per week. Pura abhi se leke March end tak. It's very, very critical. And before I throw it open for Q&A, with this millet that you're eating, also work at adding a little bit of til. So aap either aate mein dal sakte ho, ya now when you start cooking your vegetables, you know, for this whole winter, your winter is really, really harsh, right? So put til in the sabzis or dals that you're cooking so that you're getting your til. Otherwise, you know, find someone who can make you a good chikki with like dill chikki or peanut chikki, and you can even have that as a snack, as a mid-morning snack. Yeah? So is that good enough for a recap? Good. So this is something which can be followed by every single person. PCOD, diabetes, thyroid, just want to lose weight, want to know how to strike this balance between local and, you know, like desi, videsi food.